What's up, YouTube? I'm Frankie Seshi. You know that little problem you're having with your Windows 7 audio? Yeah. Let's get that fixed up today. Now, don't get me wrong. Windows 7 is, in my opinion, the best version of Windows. But it can really fall short often when it comes to audio. The Windows audio service is notorious for crashes, glitches, and mishaps. Since so many things can go wrong with the audio service, it can be quite difficult to locate the source of the problem. Many similar symptoms show up in different problems, which makes diagnosing quite tricky. A large part of auto mechanics doesn't actually involve getting your hands dirty replacing parts. Most of the time spent on a project is diagnosing the problem. Since car parts can get very expensive and are a hassle to replace, mechanics are very careful to conduct extensive testing before purchasing and replacing a part. Computers are no different. It's very important to properly diagnose a computer issue before trying to fix it. I have many videos on fixing various audio problems on Windows 7, but if you don't properly diagnose a problem and find the right video on fixing said problem, you can end up fixing the wrong thing and in turn still have audio issues. So in this video, we're going to very quickly take a few steps to properly diagnose the problem. This video will serve as a link hub that will help you find an in-depth coverage on fixing a specific issue. With that being said, annotations should be enabled, otherwise check the description for links. Okay, so you're probably not going to learn anything here, but among some of the best advice I've ever gotten from a friend was, look at the simple things first. Before you really get your hands dirty going through software related issues, you should check something terribly simple, like power and functionality. If you're trying to use a pair of headphones or speakers on your computer and it's not working, try using them on another device to test them. If they don't work there either, then you know that the device itself is probably broken. If the headphones or speakers do work on another device, now you know that the problem is with the computer. Also, it would be a very good idea to make sure that your computer is not on mute. Click the speaker and check the volume slider. Here's another tip that probably has little success, but still, start with the simple things and work your way up. If you run the troubleshooter, you just might get lucky. The troubleshooter is surprisingly decent at fixing simple audio problems, but it cannot fix some of the more complex problems you might run into. To run the troubleshooter, go to Start, Control Panel, and Troubleshooting. Then click Troubleshoot Audio Playback. The wizard will then walk you through the troubleshooter, so follow its instructions. Look for error messages. These can be extremely helpful in finding the issue. Copy the exact error message and look it up on a search engine. You will find forums with users who have experienced and fixed the same exact problem. If you see the error message, Windows audio service is not enabled, click the annotation here or check the link in the description for another video on my channel on addressing that fun little problem. The Windows audio service is the engine of your Windows audio experience. So let's take a second to ensure that the Windows audio service is working. Sometimes the service will be stopped without even notifying you. Click the Start button and type in Services. Then click Services. Go down the list to Windows and find Windows Audio. Make sure that it is enabled. If it's not, then visit the before mentioned link for my video on re-enabling it. If your audio device is not enabled and set as a default audio playback device, you won't hear audio from it. This is one of the most common problems you might run into, and it's likely that you'll run into this problem while switching from speakers to headphones or vice versa. For a comprehensive video on this procedure, click the annotation here or the link in the description. To ensure that your device is enabled, right-click the speaker icon and click Playback Devices. Go down the list and ensure that your audio device is enabled and set as a default playback device. If you cannot find your device on this list, right-click and ensure that Show Disabled Devices is selected. If your device still is not there, you may be having a driver issue or a power issue. So many problems can be attributed to something as simple as a driver. A driver is a little piece of software that helps your computer's hardware and software communicate. In this case, our hardware is our speakers. Outdated or corrupted drivers can prevent your speakers from working altogether. So try this. Go to the control panel and click Device Manager. Click the little arrow beside Sound and Video Game Controllers, then select your audio device. Typically, this is called High Definition Audio Device. The AMD High Definition Audio Device is the third-party driver that is not related to this guide. From here, I would try two things. Updating the driver by clicking Update Driver, then selecting Search Automatically for Updated Driver Software, or you can also try uninstalling the device. The device will uninstall and it will reinstall upon restarting your computer. If the device fails to reinstall due to an issue, then you should follow me to another video on my channel where I tackle driver-related problems in the audio system by clicking the annotation here or finding the link in the description. If your problem occurs as soon as Windows starts up and it's not limited to a specific application, then this step may not be helpful. But if the problem occurs only within a specific program, then it's possible that there may be a problem within the specific application's settings. Many programs require you to manually select your output device. For example, if you can hear audio through your headset as you're listening to music on the internet, but you can't hear your friend while talking on Skype, then it's possible that your headphones are not selected as the audio output device within the Skype application. To do this, simply go to the application settings, go to audio settings, and select your audio output device accordingly. Since I'm using my headset, I will use that as my output device. This example was with Skype, but many applications share the same function. If you're not seeing any error messages, and you've already run through the other steps, then here's where isolating the problem can get a little tricky. It is possible that your software is not at fault, and the problem could lie within your hardware. Most of the time, you might use onboard audio outputs. These are the ones in the back panel of your computer that are soldered directly onto the motherboard. Problems can arise with the connection of your audio ports, or the motherboard, causing them to not have power. Therefore, any audio devices you plug into that will not have a connection to your PC. Many gamers, audio enthusiasts, or music producers input and output their audio through sound cards. If your sound card isn't working properly, then you're not getting audio from it. Common reasons a sound card might not work is from damage to the card or a lack of connection to the PCI slot on the motherboard. Another frequently used audio port is right in the front of your desktop computer, and it's actually part of your computer's case. This port is powered by a small connector located at the bottom of your motherboard. These can be pretty tricky to put on correctly, so read your case's manual and your motherboard's manual in conjunction with each other to ensure proper installation, or use another audio port. If you don't have another audio port that works, you can try a very cheap solution from online retailers like Newegg or eBay. There are USB adapters that allow you to input and output sound via USB. This is a good solution because they are cheap and very easy to install. Okay, so in conclusion, there are so many potential problems with the audio in Windows 7. Feel free to click the links in the description to hop around to my other in-depth videos on fixing specific audio issues. I hope this video served as an effective troubleshooting diagnostic tool. And if you're still confused about what steps you should take to get your audio back, comment here with your problem or send me a private message. You can also effectively reach me at any other social media platform like Facebook, Twitter, Tumblr, and Instagram. If you like this kind of content and would like to see more, go ahead and subscribe. Guys, I've taken up enough of your time. I'm Frankie Seshi, and I'll see you later.